Tell me about the situation in Afghanistan before you left to come here.
I don't spend much time thinking.
Why?
Too busy with my social life.
I was a journalist in Afghanistan when I came to the United States. I was about 22 something, and then so kind of trying to find my way, and a film came from in front of me, and I saw it as an opportunity and also as a way to work for Afghan women in United States or in Afghanistan or around the world. So I got the information and I just tried it and said, okay, I'm gonna try this out, and if it works, that will be amazing. So I sent an email to Babak and the film director, mm-hmm. and we had two Zoom call, and I did the audition through online, like in a Zoom call, and mm-hmm. after that I went to California. Yes, that also helped me, and also my experience in being a journalist in Afghanistan, because I was quite comfortable in front of camera, and I knew about filmmaking a little bit, and but not acting. Mm-hmm. Yes, I was a journalist. I had to present news, or I had my own show, which was called Car Show, Old Car, and it's totally something different, and to be in a movie and the role or the character is someone who is more quiet, but she gives a lot to the audience with her quietness. While we had our distribution around the United States, our film distributors, but I had to do interviews and also be in stage and talk and do the panels. So it gives me the opportunity to talk about Afghan women, and I did that. So, and I'm gonna share this here too, because we all know about Afghanistan and what happened. Afghan girls and women are banned from school, education, working outside. And it has been more than 2 years, which schools are closed for girls. Women and girls cannot go to school, and they're not allowed. That was big part of my advocacy, and I did that. Yes, I know it doesn't make any changes, but people knows. People get the information, and mm-hmm. In every screening, I had about 200 people, 300 people, so I got the chance to talk about Afghan women. Yes, I got great feedback from my own people, because they loved it. They said, oh, you were strong. You showed other side of Afghan women, which they are strong. They can be alone, but they can find their way. They can do, they can be like any other girls from anywhere else. They can be there themselves. So this was the biggest part, or the biggest feedback I got from my own people, especially from Afghan girls. It was a real fortune cookie factory because of the budgeting and stuff. So they decided to go with the real one, and we got to film. We got to film our movie during the night, because they had to work during the day.
Yep.
I mean, the fortune cookie had to be active during the day, so we got the night shift and we were working on the night. During filming, no. Just had two or three, but after filming, because every time we had fortune cookies for our viewer or people who came to cinema or what else, to the screening, so we had fortune cookies, and I had to take like one or two because I loved fortune cookies after that, and it tastes really good, so every time I took one and I read it, so yeah, it was after filming. Yeah, he's great. So I did not know that he was famous. That's one point. Mm-hmm. So I was really comfortable with him, and if I knew it, I would have some comments or something. You know, maybe it will affect on my acting. So I did not know he was famous, or he worked for over like 15 years. My favorite film is The Kite Runner. That's my favorite film, and also I like them because I just got into film industries and I'm getting to know which type of film. I really like to watch real stories, mm-hmm. one, and sometimes fantasy, and also I watched Poor Things. Mm-hmm. I love that. That's my favorite film till now. Yeah. I have plan and I'm totally into it, and I'm working on that. Actually, I'm working on another project right now, and we will see that.